Hey everybody, it's Brian Loans from the NHRA on Fox, and this 2021 leading into 2022 offseason has been the gift that keeps on giving to the sport of NHRA Camping World Drag Racing, and I'm joined by a couple of guys who have big news to break as well leading into this 2022 season. I have Shawn Langdon, of course, the top fuel driver, and Steve Soule from CMR Construction and Roofing. Shawn, you know this better than anybody. Partnerships are the bedrock of success in this sport, and your partnership with CMR is expanding for 2022.
Yeah, we're very excited to have Steve and his group back. They were out there with us a little bit last year, so they were able to experience some of the tire smoke and the nitro and the smells and the feels and everything. But, you know, great partnership. We love having them out there, love representing CMR Roofing, and we're happy to have them back and hopefully keep that on-track success for them.
Steve, we're going to see CMR really in a high-profile fashion at about a half a dozen races as a primary sponsor on Shawn Langdon's car. And let's talk a little bit about, one, your business, and two, your understanding of how important a team is, because this Coletta Motorsports team is a big one.
You know, CMR is a company that's successful because of our people, the way that we work together, and the commitment that we have to our customers. And I think that, you know, watching the Coletta team work on their vehicles and work in conjunction with their drivers is a perfect match for us. It really helps us. It's right on message with what we try to do every day. We don't move quite as fast as them, but we try to, and that's why we say hashtag win speed matters.
You know, Shawn, one of the big things that CMR does, they bring a lot of folks out to the races that they have never been there before, and you've been involved in drag racing your whole life. Does it ever get old when you get that new fan or that new visitor to an NHRA race and they see even a warm-up for the first time? People lose their mind.
Yeah, and that's actually, that's one of the cool things about our sport, and that's really one of the cool things about what NHRA offers is every ticket a pit pass. And but also, you know, with Coletta having the hospitality, able to bring in sponsors, able to, you know, have them bring in their customers. But that interaction that you get with them, and a lot of times it's like when you're doing the warm-up and you see them, and half the time I get kind of lost in the warm-up because I'm watching everybody around because I enjoy watching their facial expressions. And then, you know, seeing them get a big whiff of the nitro, and you could see their noses burning, and they're just trying to soak it all in. But yeah, that's obviously a great thing that, you know, doesn't really get captured a lot, but you know, from inside the ropes, that's something that we always enjoy doing.
And Steve, from your side of it, talk about some of the reactions you've had from some of the folks that have seen this stuff for the first time, because even guys and girls that are into cars and into hot rodding, and maybe they've gone to a NASCAR race, nothing really compares to being in proximity to one of these 11,000 horsepower monsters.
Oh yeah, there's nothing like it. And there's nothing like sharing that experience with people for the first time. It's great for our business. It's a way to create once in a lifetime memories for folks. And gosh, it's just a lot of fun for us to be able to share, for sure.
Shawn, I know you're a guy that thrives on big competition. Heck, I know where you are right now, dynoing an engine for your bracket race dragster that you're going to be running the wheels off of when you get the opportunity this season. How much are you relishing the idea of competing in Top Fuel in 2022, a class that looks stronger than it has in a decade, maybe a decade and a half? If we just go on driving talent alone, I'm saying it's probably the toughest crop of drivers for the last maybe 20 years.
Competition is really what drives us. You know, it's the adrenaline of racing, but from a competitor standpoint, you know, I love the competition, and I love the feeling of going in and feeling like you got to get pushed to be better, and you got to, you know, always take it to the next level. But you look, I mean, we're probably going to have, on a solid, consistent basis, you know, 12 top-notch full-time season drivers, with the possibility of a couple other teams. And then you're going to have, you know, some of the really qualified teams, you know, probably run half to three quarters of the races. So there's going to be a lot of the races where it's not just going to be qualify in the top half and get your lane choice and get a, you know, a favorable matchup. It's going to be really, even if you qualify, you know, in the top five, you're probably going to have a tough draw first round. But I think that makes it more exciting for the drivers, for the teams, for the crew chiefs, you know, and especially for the fans, you know, just to have that. It's neat to be able to have, you know, full fields, and the talent list that we have on the roster for this year, you know, it's great to be a part of.
And Steve, one last question for you. We talk about full fields. We talk about the attendance we're going to be seeing this year. Let people know the size of the outfit that CMR is, because this is a very significant operation that you guys have.
Yeah, no. In 2020, we ranked as the 10th largest roofing company in the United States. I'm expecting our rankings to have climbed significantly, you know, possibly within the top six. We'll see. But we grew about 30%, 35% last year. And I think that our participation with NHRA and other motorsports has really helped us recruit people in a time where a lot of companies are struggling to find folks. We got people knocking on the door wanting to come on board with us, helps us pick the right people, put them in place, and helps us continue to grow. You know, CMR, thankfully, you know, $173 million worth of revenue in 2021. So we're looking to blow the doors off of that in 2022. So great to see good crowds. Great to have tons of folks at the races. I really appreciate everything, for the entire Coletta team. Great drivers, great hosts. They make this fun. And, you know, you didn't ask me what I thought about the field, but I think we got the three best drivers out there, hands down, and we're going to have the number one crew as well. So I'm looking forward to seeing a lot of wins this stack this year, and hopefully a championship as well. And I think we can.
We didn't pay him to say that either.
The confidence is evident, and boy, it should be. Three of the best drivers in the sport are statistically 100% correct, and their records speak for themselves. Steve and Sean, thanks so much for taking some time to hang out with us today.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
They will be at the NHRA Winter Nationals in just a couple weeks in Pomona, California. It may make Steve cringe, but we're going to blow the roof off the place. It is going to be a spectacular way to begin the season. We're looking at fields at the Winter Nationals we haven't seen in more than half a decade in terms of car counts, and you should be there. Go to NHRA.com today to get your tickets and watch great drag racing in beautiful Southern California in the middle of February. You can't beat it. I'm Brian Loans. Thanks for watching. We'll be back soon.